Hi, my name is Wenlin Ziada, New York City-based director and creator of theater, television, and film, and also proud Phoenix Global Artist Ambassador. Today, I am thrilled to be speaking with the award-winning oil painter, Wang Huibin. For more on Mr. Wang Huibin, you can read more about him right below this video. But in the meantime, here is my interview with the incredible Wang Huibin. Well, good morning from the West, and it is nighttime in Beijing, China, and I am so excited to be joined by the award-winning oil painter, Mr. Wang Huibin, and somewhere in the East. Chu, where are you right now?
Nepal.
We are joined by the amazing Chu, who is going to be once again on translation. Mr. Wang Huibin, I am so grateful that you are joining me today, and I have loved researching you in your incredible painting. I want to know, where were you born and when did you realize that oil painting was going to be your form of expression in expressing your light and talent?
Thank you, well,
过去的背景做了一系列研究中，他非常喜欢您的艺术作品，所以他的第一个问题是，能不能跟我们介绍一下您出生的地方，还有您是从什么时候发现自己对油画有天赋？哦，我呢，这个是出生在江苏，中国江苏连云港灌南县，对。 我在大概是在七岁的时候，我家里边我父亲就是画画的，这个我小时候呢是画的是国画，但是呢后来就是长大以后呢就是对西方的这个艺术更感兴趣，所以呢我呢这个后来上大学以后呢我上的就是油画，对。
您可以都说完，这样我们不会因为三方的网络延迟而耽误时间。
啊，好的，对，后来呢，我呢这个在上学的时候呢，我呢，我们中国呢是赶上八五新潮，八五新潮呢是对现代艺术呢，我正好是赶上它的这个八五新潮末期，后来我就这个对西方的艺术呢各种门类的艺术都研究过遍。 开始呢，表现主义啊，这个抽象主义啊，抽象艺术啊，超现实主义啊，这个很多的艺术呢，我就研究过了一个遍。后来呢，我就慢慢的形成了自己的这个独特的这个鸟笼系列。我的鸟笼系列呢，它主要是这个就是东西方都有养鸟的鸟笼。 我呢，突然发现呢，我是小时候呢，突然发现就是在零几年的时候，我突然发现了这个有一个老头啊，就是一个老先生在这个提笼架里，哎，后来呢，我看到他那个鸟笼呢，这个他的那鸟笼呢，就是打开的时候啊，它里边这个非常美丽的一种鸟叫云雀，它就飞到了个空中。 我就奇怪了，我说，哎，你这个鸟这个放飞的时候，你怎么能跟这个鸟会飞回来？后来呢，这个哎，那个老先生就讲了说，等半小时以后，这个鸟呢就会从空中飞回来。所以他的这个养鸟的技术是太高明，哎呀，就像那个这个一刹那间就一下打开了我的思维。 所以笼子呢，它既有禁锢的一面，变成鸟呢，又有自由的一面。所以开始我的作品就是早期的作品里边还有具体的鸟笼形象，后来呢，我就给它异化成了这个，就是人也是个鸟笼，鸟也是个鸟笼，就是自由禁锢嘛与自由的一种悖论关系，我就找到了这个语言。 那这个，你鸟是云雀是吗？啊，对对对，云雀，对，那种鸟呢是非常野性的，是很难这个驯养驯化的，所以这个老先生呢是一个驯化鸟的技术达到非常高明的地方。后来我呢这个就是这个大概是在这个上学的时候呢，喜欢看一本书叫钱钟书的《围城》。《围城》呢，它呢这个就有城内的人像 城外跑，城外的人向城内进，正好跟我的鸟笼呢，这个鸟笼与鸟之间的关系呢，就是发生了这个非常一个契合点。那么我就发现了这个生活中有诸多的这个社会现象呢、啊、这个家庭啊，这个社会呀、啊、这个各种的这个可以都能用鸟笼来表达，所以我的画出来的东西呢就有点形而上的意思感觉了啊。对，是的，
非常感谢您，很具体，我帮您翻译一下。Well, it's actually quite interesting how he started. So he was born in Lianyungang, Jiangsu province, the place that I also came from. And his father was a painter, and he was introduced to watercolor painting as a child. When he turned adult, however, he became more drawn to Western medium and oil painting especially. So in his schooling time, it turned out to be just during the 85 youth stream, Ba Wu Chao. So I think in his college, he became really interested in the expressionism, abstract art, also super realism, different forms of art. And how he came to create the cage theory, it began with a very great anecdote. He saw this old gentleman when he was younger. And this guy was a talented trainer of skylark. Skylark is a type of bird that's quite wild and is very difficult to train. But however, he saw this gentleman, he opened his cage, and then 30 minutes later, the lark came back. You know, it's like something, it's like an aha moment for him. So from then on, the cage, from a symbol of confinement, became a very paradoxical expression, because it can also mean freedom at the same time. So he would like to use the cage theory to symbolize a lot of social issues, families, jobs, countries, and he would like to represent this conundrum of freedom and also confinement. So next he said that he's also very much drawn to the book, it's a fiction by a famous Chinese writer, Qian Zhongshu, the fortress besieged Weicheng. And in it, there was a famous line. So Qian Zhongshu portrayed marriage as a fortress where the people outside wanted to go in, but the married couple, the people inside the forest, they want to get out. So that's also the thing that he would like to, represent in his artwork.
That's absolutely amazing. My goodness. And that whole image of the caged bird, there's so many beautiful symbols and allegories within that. And unfortunately in our world today, but the fact that you're able to take a positive look at it and look at it as a sign of freedom, especially once the bird, you know, can be released and not be confined. I also want to speak a little bit about your Provoking Blue and White series. How that came about for you. Your use of color is so emotionally moving. Do you find that when you're working, you realize while you're doing it how universal the language of your work actually is?
Yeah. 王老师，他非常感谢您刚才对于鸟笼鸟那一段的回答。他能感受到这种自由与束缚同时存在的这种非常两难的境地，还有一种很奇特的以他为主题的一种艺术表达方式。他接下来想问的是您的惹青花的这一系列，然后他能感受到饱含了情感，能跟我们分享一下这其中的创作过程吗？
可以，我的惹青花呢是在我呢这个画鸟笼之前，这个后来呢，这个就是惹青花呢，我呢，这个中国的这个就是名字呢叫灿嘛，是吧？那就是呢，这个中国的这个名字的代名词。那我呢，这个就是可能是看到我那个惹青花那个叫青花引导革命，是吧？这个呢，这个 这个惹青画呢，我是用的是一种符号化的东西，在我们的这个收藏界，比如这个收藏瓷瓶啊，比如像元明清的这个瓷瓶里边，上面会有会有青花的一种叫蚕丝纹，我呢就是将它符号化的东西，符号化了以后呢，它就有一种这个格式化的，说这个呢，我代表的是一种这个文化的，这个传统文化的这个意思。但是呢，后来我又将这个，比如我画的那个叫《青花引导革命》，我就借用了这个德拉克洛瓦的这个自由引导人民，但是我用中国的熊猫呢，又消解了一种暴力革命，这个就是一种血腥的革命啊。就我这个有点这个就是用儿童化的这个形式来消解暴力革命，就是我呢这个画的这个惹青画系列，比如像我呢儿童画的一样，比如手里边我并不是拿这个枪啊这个刀啊之类的，但是我呢是笔画成这个手型，那这个呢是一种对呢这个对这个人类的这个纷争啊太过这个血腥，我觉得人类呢应该和平相处，应该以和平为这个方式。我觉得呢这个用儿童画去反讽暴力革命是我的初衷。对。
嗯，你刚才说的暴力那个提到了一个人名，是能再跟我解释一下吗？我没有太听懂。
对，那个叫法国的这个艺术家画的一个公共的有一个叫自由引导人民。我呢是将这个自由引导人民呢这个进行了消解啊，就是以他的公共语境，我进行了用我自己的方式去消解，传达的又是跟他不一样的意思，就是以和平为主题的，以文化的这个方式来革命的。就是我们人类我们中国需要创新，需要呢这个打破思想的这个樊笼啊，那这个呢就是我早期的惹青花系列呢，后来就是某种形式上呢虽然不太一样，但是跟我的笼子呢也是慢慢的会吻合起来，其实我的理念呢基本上还是一致的，就是我用的这个载体不太一样。对。
He went quite in depth into the intuition that came into that work. So, 青花, I believe in this sense, it's the blue and white porcelain, the traditional porcelain from China. And you must know the famous artwork, the people leading the liberty.No, actually, sorry. One moment. I think it's called the Liberty Leading the People. It's by a French painter, Eugene. And let me show you just this.
啊，对对对对，是的。
Yes, I'm familiar with it. Yes.
这幅画。
As a blueprint, and he actually substitute the people with panda. So panda, it's a Chinese symbol. It's also peace. And by cartoonized.This famous artwork, he made it almost suitable for kids to actually appreciate. So by doing that, he would like to reduce the power of violence, dampen the, the violent thing that came with the revolution. That's his...Basically, his goal, his dream is to hope and call out for peace among people rather than, war and violence. So panda is the best symbol for that.
I absolutely love it. I think that is so creative. The way that you were able to look at a piece of artwork that is already existing and make it your own, a universal language of peace through a panda,I mean, what could be better than that? I am so, so grateful for your time today. And I cannot wait to come to Beijing someday soon, once all this mess is over, to meet you, go to one of your exhibitions, go to your studio in Beijing, And again, once again, Chu, I am so grateful for you as well. Thank you both so much.